A very good morning, class. So today we'll do this topic of your English grammar, and this topic is going to come in your half yearly syllabus. The name of this topic is adjectives, degrees of comparison. You've already done this topic in your earlier classes. So we'll today have a quick revision of this topic. Okay, so adjectives, degrees of comparison. I'll read out these three sentences. Gautam is a clever boy. Krishna is cleverer than Gautam. Rustam is the cleverest boy in the class. Okay, so we may sometimes want to compare two or more persons or things with regard to a particular quality that they both all have. Okay, so now if you look into sentence A, which simply states that Gautam is clever, that is, Gautam has the quality of cleverness. Means here Gautam is clever and he just has the quality of cleverness. Here you have not compared Gautam with any of the other boys. But now if you will look into sentence B, there is comparison between two boys, that is Krishnan and Gautam. So here compares two boys, that is Gautam and Krishnan, with regards to cleverness, the quality cleverness. And here they say is that Krishnan is more cleverer. Okay, so in other words, Krishnan has more quality of cleverness than Gautam. And now if you look into that, Krishnan is more cleverer. Okay, so in other words, Krishnan has more quality of cleverness than Gautam. And now if you look into this sentence 3, that is, compares more than two boys. Here, they have compared more than two boys. So if you look into sentence 1, in this they have not compared Gautam with any of the boys. It was solely about Gautam. In the second sentence, they have compared two boys. And in the third sentence, they have compared more than. So here, all the boys in the class regarding cleverness. Okay, you have compared more than two boys, that are all the boys in the class, that to the related to the quality cleverness, and says that Rustam is the cleverest. So what you should note is that in all the three cases, you're using different forms of the same adjective. Okay, what basically is an adjective that will describe the quality of, or the quality or the quantity, whatever we are talking about, of a noun or a pronoun. Okay. So here you, what you have done, you have used different forms of the same adjectives, that is clever. So here you have used clever, cleverer and cleverest. So what basically is a degree of comparison? When you use adjectives in this way for the purpose of comparison, it is basically known as degree of comparison. Okay, so further, degree of comparisons are positive degree, comparative degree and superlative degree. So let us just look into what are positive, superlative and comparative degree. Okay, so first we'll talk about positive degree. The first step is called the positive degree, when we simply talk of one person or thing having a quality. So here in positive degree we just talk about one person, that is having the quality clever. In comparative degree, which is the second step, here we compare more than two persons or things with regard to a particular quality and superlative degree. So first is short, shorter, shortest, dark, darker, darkest. So basically in positive degree, see, as you have seen, the comparative degree is usually forming by adding er and the superlative by adding est. So in comparative, you are just adding er at the last of that adjective, and in superlative, you're adding est at the last of that adjective. So we'll quickly, you know, read out these. Short, shorter, shortest, dark, darker, darkest, lovely, lovelier, loveliest, bold, bolder, boldest, young, younger, youngest, happy, happier, happiest, big, bigger, biggest, hot, hotter, hottest. Okay, good. So here are some exceptions always there where you will not add EST. See, good, better, best, well, better, best, bad, worse, worst, ill, worse, worst. Okay, so here also they have given you a chart. Many, more, see, many in case of number, much in quantity. So many more, most, much more, most, well, better, best, little, less, lesser, least, late, later, later, okay? Latest, last, old, older, elder, oldest, and eldest. Okay, so now here we have revised the degrees of comparison of adjectives. I hope you have understood all the points that I have explained you. Okay, so now kindly I'll send you a worksheet and
one
just
person
or thing having a quality. So here we are just here in positive degree, we just talk about one person that is having the quality clever. In comparative degree, which is the second step, here we compare more than two persons or things with regard to a particular quality that is cleverer. And in case of superlative degree, that is the third and the final step, what we do basically in that, we compare more persons or things, means more than two, with more than two persons or thing with regard to a particular quality that is cleverest. So here is a proper chart of positive, comparative and superlative degrees. So first is short, shorter, shortest, dark, darker, darkest. So basically in positive degree, see, as you have seen, the comparative degrees usually forming by adding ER and the superlative by adding ESD. So in comparative, you are just adding ER at the last of that adjective, and in superlative, you're adding EST at the last of that adjective. So we'll quickly, you know, read out these. Short, shorter, shortest, dark, darker, darkest, lovely, lovelier, loveliest, bold, bolder, boldest, young, younger, youngest, happy, happier, happiest, big, bigger, biggest, hot, hotter, hottest. Okay, good. So here are some exceptions always there where you will not add EST. See, good, better, best, well, better, best, bad, worse, worst, ill,